is more than conquerors. This church is more than conquerors. Hallelujah. The church of Christ. We bless any other church in the city, Lord. We bless their pastor. We bless their leaders. We bless the worship team. We bless the deacons and the usher. We are not jealous. No, jealousy is not part of the kingdom. We bless them because they are the body of Christ with us. So we, the body of Christ, today, we say together, yes, we are more than conquerors through Christ Jesus. And Father, revival is about to take place. Hallelujah. Harvest is going to be to take place. And I know that nothing can stop of the move of God in my heart. And nothing will shall be able, because today I want to say, yes, I'm here. I'm here to worship, and I'm here to honor, and I'm here to give you praise to do. So today we give you honor in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Nothing is impossible through Christ Jesus, who saves us. believe. We believe that Christ can do anything.
There is joy.
joy in the house of the Lord. There is joy in the house of the Lord. There is joy. There is joy. Thank you, God, for you have set us free, for we are happy, God. We can dance in your house, God, with nobody chasing us, without us being persecuted, God. We want to thank you, God, because we have freedom. We have freedom to exalt you, to praise you, God. For God, freedom reigns here, God. You reign here in your freedom. God, freedom reigns. Freedom reigns in the house because we have freedom. The freedom reigns in the house of the Lord. The freedom reigns in the house of the Lord. Freedom reigns. Freedom reigns. Freedom reigns in the house of the Lord. Freedom reigns in the house of the Lord. Freedom reigns. Freedom reigns. There is freedom. There is freedom. Freedom. There is joy in the house of the Lord. There is joy. There is joy. There is joy in the house of the Lord. There is joy in the house of the Lord. There is joy. There is joy. There is joy in the house of the Lord. There is joy in the house of the Lord. With our dance, we want to thank you, God, with our praise, God. Thank you.
to the King of Kings, God. And thank you, God, for dying on the cross for us, God. Thank you, God, for giving up your life for us, God. You took those nails to the hand, God, for us to be saved. The King of Kings, you died for us. But on the third day, God, you rose. You rose, you conquered the grave, and you gave us the victory, God.
Forever he is lifted high.
Come on, just say forever, 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 forever. Come on, just say. The enemy needs to hear this. Your problem, your situation needs to hear this. The financial problem needs to hear this. Come on, the sickness needs to hear this. Singing, it says, forever you're alive, forever you're alive. We're saying, well, death, you cannot defeat us because Jesus Christ defeats you on the cross. Sickness, you cannot touch us. Nothing can separate us from the love of God. So right now, not just sing to the Lord, but sing to that promise. It says, forever he will be. He will be king. Forever he will be my Lord. When you sing, you know what? You're establishing the kingdom of God against that sickness, against that problem, against that situation in your marriage, and against that situation at school, against that situation at work. If you feel depressed, come on, just start singing, Lord, forever you are alive, forever. Come on, when you glorify God, God crush the enemy. Declare that he's good. Declare that he's marvelous. Declare. David used to say in his Psalms, you are my rock. You're my fortress. You're my deliverer. You're my shepherd. Come on, start taking the Lord your God as your healer. Come on, start declaring, you are my healer. You are my savior. You are my fortress. Hallelujah. God has so many different needs. If you have a financial problem, say, God, you are my provider. If you have been sick, you say, Lord, you are my healer. If you have a war, if you have a battle, you say, Lord, you are my Lord. You are the Lord of the armies. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, if you feel lonely, you say, Holy Spirit, you are the advocate. You are my helper. You are the one that brings me hope. Come on, if you don't have peace, and if you are stressed, and you are overwhelmed, say, God, you are my peace. You are my peace. Come on. Come on. Release right now what he is for you. Because he defeated the enemy. He conquered death, the world.
Say, God, you are my healer. You are the one that heals my body. Not the pills, not the medicine. You are my healer. You are Jehovah Rapha. Somebody needs provision here. You are my provider. Come on, it's no extra hours. It's no overtime. What's going to pay your bills? He is your provider. Come on, let's seek the kingdom of heaven first, church. Let's seek the kingdom of heaven first, and everything else will be added to you, the Lord Jesus said. So right now, say, God, you are the one that will open and move this situation. You are the one that will remove the enemy. Remember what I said last week? God said, this is not your battle. It's my battle. Father, I take that, and you are Jehovah Nishi, Jehovah Sitkenu. My standard, you are the one that goes before me. Shh. Yes, 2017, it will be a year of great challenges. But Lord, you are with me. And you are with all of us. And nothing can separate us from the love of God. Nothing shall be able. Nothing. I grab in your hand right now, Jesus. You are my Lord. I grab in your hand, Lord Jesus. I'm going to stick to your plan. I'm going to stick to the idea of what you have for me. I'm going to stick to the perfect plan that you have for me, God. Forgive me, I have been rebellious. Forgive me, I have been disobedient. Forgive me, I have meditated the word as I'm supposed to do it. Forgive me, I have not have forgiveness in my heart as I need to do that. Come on, right now, establish the kingdom of God in your heart. Remove the eyes of the enemy in the situation, and sometimes we become bitter because we put too much attention to the enemy. And sometimes we feel frustrated because we feel pity and because we feel sorry about us. But God is releasing something right now. It says, listen, you are more than conquerors through me, says Jesus. So embrace yourself, embrace who you are, and start declaring who I am for you. And start putting the eyes in Jesus. Start putting the eyes in what's for you from the glory, not from what the world can do. The enemy came to Jesus and said, Jesus, if you worship me, if you bow down, I'll give you the kingdoms. And Jesus said, it's written. It's written. You're only going to serve God. And today you can say, God is written. And you can tell the enemy is written. I am more than conquerors. You can tell the depression and the sickness and the battle that you have in your mind and the double-minded that you might have. And you can declare, it's written. We are. I am more than conquerors. Woo! And when we sing forever, he will be, that casts a headache to the devil. So don't be afraid to sing this song. Don't be afraid to say, Dad, where is your sting? Depression, where is your sting? Then Jesus defeated you. I don't worry about what one man can do. I don't worry about what the enemy can do, because I'm joined. I am one with Holy Spirit. He's greater than one that is in me. Hallelujah. But you have to declare it with your lips. Come on, the Bible says the blessing is in your mouth. That life and death is in your mouth. What are you saying today? You're saying, poor me? And you're saying, oh, please, God. Or you're saying, I am a daughter. I'm a son. I have a healer. I have a savior. I am more than conquerors. I have the wisdom of God. I have the mind of Christ. Well, my body is healed. Hallelujah. Come on, start declaring the blessing upon your life right now. Don't wait for pastor to start declaring blessing. You have the total authority. You have the power right now. This is an anointing moment right now. Come on, bless your financials. Whatever you bound here, it will be bound in heaven. But whatever you release here, it will be released in heaven. Sometimes we are asking too much, and we feel too pity and too worried about us. But we need to still declare the word of God. And today I want to declare, this church is more than conquerors. Hallelujah. Through Christ Jesus. This church has a healer. This church has a provider. This church has a pastor. This church has a shepherd. His name is Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah. So we are more than conquerors. And nothing shall be able to separate us. Not even the weather. We're not worried about snow and rain. We are here because we love him. We are here because we want more of him. And no snow and no rain. And nothing can stop us from coming to the house of the Lord. So right now start declaring, I am more than conquerors. And we're going to say one more time. We're going to say, death, where is your sting? It's not here. It's not in my body. It's not in my flesh. Sickness, where are you? You are in the cross. You have been defeated by thy Lord Savior. He healed me with his stripes. My mind belongs to Jesus. I'm renewing my mind to be the head and not the tail. Hallelujah. Come on, let's say one more time. Crisis, what are you sting? You are defeated. Depression, what do you think? You have been defeated by my Jesus. Hallelujah.
Take the glory.
to the King of Kings. Come on. He'll be a mighty, a mighty, a mighty on us. Come on, if you are victorious, if you are the head and not the tail, if you are healed, if you are blessed, if you are prospered, give a mighty shout to Jesus today. Say, go and say somebody. Go and tell somebody, you are more than conquerors. Come on, go and tell, say, you are more than conquerors. Not because you can do it, but because what Jesus has done on the cross. Woo. Listen, we have to understand something. We are more than victorious and conquerors because He has already done it. Shandara mama makete rimanara makete rimataro moshe. Come on right now, take your envelope right now. If you have an offering, if you don't have anything, grab an envelope, whatever. Doesn't matter. Because sometimes we say, oh God, please, please, please help me to pay the rent. Oh God, please, please provide a job. But we forgot that we are fighting from the victory, not for the victory. He already blessed us. It's not that His will open, it's that He already opened the heavens. The Bible says in Ephesians that we are already blessed in heavenly places. The problem is that sometimes we are the ones that get the blessed stuck in the heavens. Listen, when we don't obey, that's why the Bible says in Malachi, test me, if you give tithes and offerings, if you put God first, He will open the heavens. It's not that He will, it's already opening Him, but He's waiting for us to move on faith. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's why when financial crisis starts in our lives, we cannot stop giving. If you say, oh, I lost my job, I cannot tithe, that's a lie of the enemy. Because right there is God testing you, and right there God is testing your faith. I mean, when you have money, it's really easy to give. And you give your tithes and offerings. But you know what? The enemy, when we have crisis, that's where we have to stand in our faith. I don't know how the system works here in Canada, but when you get fired, you get your severance. But when you quit, you don't get anything. That's crazy. When I quit my job, I didn't get a penny after 10 years of working there. But for that reason, I didn't stop my tithes and offerings. I know God was testing me. I don't have enough for food, but you know what? It's that widow that He came to the altar. And Jesus saw everybody putting offerings and tithes. But she came with a coin. The leftover, nothing left. And she probably said, God, I don't have anything else but just this coin. And I'm going to put it in the altar. And Jesus said, she gave more than everybody else. Because it's not about how much we're giving, it's how much they're acting in our hearts. If you don't pass the test of prosperity, God, you never will see the glory of God in the financials. So right now, just by under the anointing of the house, come on, just take your tithes and offerings. And I'm going to ask everybody to give something. I don't care. I don't have to see how much. It's not my business. It's with you and God. But something that I know is that we have to move our faith. Some people don't believe in giving. I believe in giving. Some people say, but that's from the Old Testament. Well, in the New Testament, it's even greater, the glory. So actually, you have to give more. Not less, but more. Because the Bible says we are from glory to glory. Glory to glory. Not from backwards. No. God never moved backwards. God always moved forward. So then anointing right now, just grab your envelope. Say, God, you are my provider. It's written. Come on, say with me. It's written. You will provide according to your riches and glory in my life. I declare 2017 a year of glory in my financials. Not because what can I say for what my boss says, not for what the government is going to say, I don't even have to check the news because I'm not worried about economy anymore. I'm not worried about layoff anymore because I am trusting you, God. I am trusting you. I am trusting you that you are my shepherd and I shall not be in want. I might trust in that you provide everything that I need according to the riches in glory. And I declare what Malachi says. I am testing you, God. I am testing you that I'm giving today to you. Not to men, but according to Melchizedek's order. That it says that in here man shall receive this, but in heavenly places God receive it. And I declare that the year that is coming is going to be abundantly. It's going to be multiplication. And then I won't have a room enough to store it because I will see your glory in my financials. So today I declare that you are the owner of gold and silver because it's written. And you will give everything that I need. You will provide everything. You will pay my bills. You will pay the bills of this church. We do not depend on people. We depend on you, Holy Spirit. You are, and we honor you today. We are tithes and offerings and give you praise and honor because you are King of kings and Lord of lords, and we are fighting from the victory. We are more than victorious, more than conquerors in our financials. In Jesus' mighty name, we declare, say, we say all this, amen and amen. And if you believe it, come to the altar. Come to the altar and say, God, you are my provider. Woo! Lord, you are my provider. Hallelujah. Harvest of glory. Harvest of glory. You will bless my job. Come on, right there in the altar, say, Lord, bless my job. Bless my financials. Bless my ideas. Come on. Father, I pray right now that businessmen and business woman become real in this church. Hallelujah. Some are going to be employed but in a good job with a good salary, but I believe some people are going to be business people. And I declare people with businesses here in Jesus' mighty name, because the glory is going to touch this ground. And the Bible says that everything that we do with our hands shall prosper. Psalm 23 says that we are a planted tree beside the living waters, and everything that we do shall prosper. The Bible says that we are prospered not because we are good, it's because the river is close to us. And we are those trees, Lord. So we declare prosperity in our lives. Come on, let's declare one more right now, prosperity. It says, Lord, I declare prosperity. And now I'm not speaking about money only. I'm speaking about healing, blessing, joy, peace. That's the prosperity of God. God is a fullness God. So come on, declare it with me. I declare prosperity in my life. I declare prosperity in my family. I declare prosperity in those that are around me. And I declare prosperity in this ministry. And I declare prosperity in my generation. Come on, everybody. I declare prosperity in my generation. My children and my grandchildren. Hallelujah. Blessing. Right through the bones. The anointing of the Holy Ghost. The anointing of the Holy Ghost. The anointing of the Holy Spirit. Father, I declare that my children will have enough money to have their own houses, full pay. And I declare that my children will pay the university of their children, and my grandchildren, they will have more than enough. And I will teach them that it's not because I'm good, it's not because we're smart, it's not because we have good businesses, it's because we have Holy Spirit in our lives. So we declare 2017 a great harvest in every area. And come on, say, Lord, and I will testify. Come on, declare it. And I will testify of your goodness. I'm not going to be quiet. I'm going to be opening my lips and to declare your goodness to all people around me. In Jesus' mighty name. Come on, if you believe in the prosperity of God, give a mighty applause to him today. Come on, let's give a mighty applause to the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen, 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 amen. Thank you, worship team. Woo. Hallelujah. Somebody asked me, "The pastor, do you have salary?" I said, "No, I don't." And you know, he said, how do you live? He said, I live by faith. I don't have salary. And this is how much I receive every week. How you do it? He says, by the grace of God. Declaring every morning, he is my provider. Come on, say with me, he is my provider. Holy Spirit, you are. Without you, we cannot do anything. Without your presence, we cannot keep moving forward. But today we welcome you, Holy Spirit, to this anointing moment. You are the anointing. You are the glory. You are, Holy Spirit, the pastor, the leader, the teacher, the master. You are everything in our lives. Since the day we met you, we're addicted to you. We cannot live without having communion with you every day. We would die without hearing your voice every morning. But I pray you can come right now and speak your word. And I pray right now that you can fill this vessel of clay with your glory, to teach us, to reveal your presence and to reveal the truth of your word and the instructions that we need in our church, in this ministry, in order to be ready for a great harvest. So we welcome you, Holy Spirit. I open my ears to hear your voice. I don't hear the voice of the stranger. I hear your voice, Holy Spirit. So please, speak to my heart. Circumcise my heart with your word. Because it's like a sword, like it's double sharp, that it goes inside of us. So circumcise my heart, God, because I want to be ready. Because I know you call me for a great move of God, for a great harvest. And I don't want to miss that moment of glory. So we welcome you today. And we say, speak, Holy Spirit. This is your house. This is your church. This is the church of your Jesus Christ. We are your servants. We are your disciples. We are here to hear your voice, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. And we say, amen. And amen. And amen. I have a special word for all of us. Straight from the Holy Spirit, and I believe it's for one in each of us. So we're gonna let the kids go for a class, but we're gonna stay the other ones here, and I'm gonna ask everybody to open your Bibles. I believe in 2 Corinthians chapter 7. God is gonna release something, and I hope you can just open your hands like this and just say, God, I'm gonna receive it, because you have to receive it. Because it's not only just going just through our ears, but say, God, I'm going to receive it because I'm ready today to receive your teaching and your word. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. Remember when we need to understand that we need to, when the Apostle Peter came to the temple and he told the man that he was sick, he says, I don't have gold and silver. But he said, look at me. He creates faith on him. And I believe we need to be ready with faith to receive the word of God. Amen? We need to be ready to receive what God is doing in our lives. And I believe the word for all of us is 2 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 1. And if you have your Bible, please open it right there. Do not trust just in the screen. I wanna ask everybody here to open your Bibles here and just to read the word of God. Do not read just the screen, but read the word right there, whatever you have it. And it says, therefore, are you there? The screen is there. It says, therefore, having this with promises. Say with me, promises. Come on, say with me, promises. Come on, are you here, church? Say with me, promises. Come on, says this. Therefore, having these promises, beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and the spirit. And can we read that part? Perfecting holiness and the fear of God. I want to repeat it one more time. Therefore, having these promises, beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and the spirit, perfecting, so we meet that perfecting holiness in the fear of God. Amen. Amen. Let me read it in two more versions that I have here. There's the New International Version. And it says this: therefore, since we have these promises, dear friends, let us purify ourselves from everything that contaminates body and spirit, perfecting holiness out of reverence for God. And the New Living Translation says this: because we have these promises, which promises many, so we mean many. Dear friends, let us cleanse ourselves from everything that can defile our body or spirit. And let us work toward complete holiness, because we fear God. Amen and amen. I don't know if you understand what God is saying today, but I believe the key word for today's message from the Holy Spirit is one word, and that's holiness. Say with me, holiness. Come on, say with me, holiness. 2017 is around the corner, and right now people are getting resolutions. And I was checking a little bit on the internet about the top 10 resolutions, and it's save money and have a trip, reduce what I'm eating. You know, some people say I'm gonna quit smoking, I'm gonna quit drinking, I'm gonna. There's some people that say I'm gonna call my dad and my mom. That's a good resolution. Call my loved ones, and I'm gonna save for college, and I'm gonna save for my house. And different resolutions that people are already thinking right now. So what is going to be my resolution for next year? But I believe the resolution for all of us, especially for this ministry, is one word. Say with me, holiness. Come on, say with me, holiness. Listen, we have a great check. We have a great check that is already given by God to the church of Jesus Christ, to the body of Jesus Christ. That's why the Bible says with all these promises, the Bible says that we have great promises, amen? And all the promises are yes and amen in our lives. And I believe God is waiting for us to take it, to believe that it's for us, and to believe that we need them, and to believe that we can take them. But the Bible says here, cleanse yourself from all the filthiness and all the sin and everything that it gets stuck in our spirit and our flesh. And as the Bible says, perfecting holiness in the fear of God. Some others said, perfecting holiness out of the reverence of God. And some others said, let us work toward complete, so we may complete holiness, because we fear God. So we have to understand something. God is waiting for us to start a resolution for 2017 according to His word and holiness. Because we have to understand something. Sometimes we have plans. We're going to go to this college. We're going to take this job. I'm going to apply for this. I'm going to save money. Maybe I'm going to buy this and I'm going to buy that. But we need to start a plan in holiness. Because holiness is part of who we are. And holiness is the key of awakening. Say with me, awakening. Come on, say with me, revival. Yes, we have to understand that the check is already given, but God is waiting for us to take a plan of holiness. How are we going to become holy in this 2017? And what can I do to remove the filthiness of my spirit, remove the filthiness of my flesh? I need to remove this out of my cell phone. I need to remove these contacts out of my list. I need to stop talking to these people. Maybe I have to stop going to these places. I need to start working and perfecting the holiness in my life, because the holiness will bring the glory of God to my life. And the First Peter chapter 1, verse 15, the Bible says this: but as He called you is holy, it says, you also, can you read it with me? You also be holy in all your conduct, because it is written, be holy, for I am holy. New Living Translation says this: but now you must be holy in everything you do, just as God who chose you is holy. For the scriptures say, you must be holy as I am holy. You have to understand something. God is waiting for us to start a planning in our lives to be holy, to walk in righteousness more than before. Say with me, more than before. And why I'm speaking today this? Because I believe we are the ones that are called to manifest the holiness of God in our lives. Yes, this is not for brand new people. This is not for new believers. This is for people that are in the house of God. This is for people that believe in revival and awakening, because it's not just emotions. It's not a good thinking. Oh, it's not just reading the word. It's not just all praising God, but it's living a life full of holiness in our lives. And I believe that's for all of us. I need to start saying, Holy Spirit, what you want me to remove out of my life? You want me to cancel this app? You want to remove me? You want to remove the computer out of my life? You know, sometimes we need to understand something. Big steps needs to take place in our lives. If we really want to see the glory of God, if we really want to see the presence of God in our lives, holiness must be in place in our lives every day. Holiness in our mind, holiness in our hearts. And I believe what Jesus said in Matthew 5:8. Because Jesus said, look the way it says Matthew 5:8. It says this, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see, what? God. Listen, if we keep walking in this 2017 in the same way that we are going to move in 2017, we're gonna see much of God. But if we really want to see God, how many want to see the glory of God? Amen? Oh, you have to work in holiness. You have to work in your heart. You have to say, God, what I need to clean. You know? So it's like you know, when you have a home, and I don't know, actually one of the biggest business in Canada is renovations, you know? That's a lot of money. I don't know how, I cannot tell you how many millions of dollars a year people spend in renovation. But some people get tired of the same walls, same paint, same color, same sofa, same thing, you know, same kitchen. See, some people say, well, let's do something, renovation time, you know. And I believe that's what's happening. We cannot keep the same house and the same thing. We have to go higher. Say with me, higher. Come on, say with me, renovation time. And I believe that renovation is in holiness. I believe the renovation is saying, God, what I need to remove out of my kitchen, what I need to remove out of my mind, what I need to remove out of my tablet, what I need to remove out of my heart. Because maybe this year you felt pity all year around, and that's no holiness, and you have to say, God, I need to just get rid of this thing for next year. If I really want to see the glory, I need to prepare my heart. Jesus said this, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see what? God. Our world needs holiness. Our world that is in the middle of the darkness needs people that live righteousness. Needs people that say, you know what, that's wrong. Oh, let's everybody lie. Oh, let's steal. Oh, let's do this. You say, no, I'm not. Why not? Because somebody has to do the right thing here. Somebody has to do the right thing in my job. Somebody has to do the right thing in my neighborhood. Somebody has to say, leave the, you know, hand in class and say, teacher, that's wrong. That's not appropriate. But somebody has to say it. We need to. The Bible says that we are, so we mean we are, the light of the world. In Hebrews chapter 12, verse 14, the Bible says this, pursue peace with all people, and what? And holiness, without which no one, what? Come on, read it. Come on, don't be afraid. Which one? Oh, yes, you can feel God, you can experience God, but you're not going to see it if you're not working and perfecting holiness in your life. Listen, we don't want a good people that close their eyes with and tie, and we don't want people that scream and yell. We need people that work in holiness, not just here in church, but every day in their lives. We need people that work holiness in the car, listening holy music. Because still Christian here that is still, oh, I want to see God, but it's still listening, boom, 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 stick that, don't glorify God. We need to understand something. We need to work in our holiness. Say with me, holiness. Come on, say with me, holiness. Yes, we have to understand that anything that is not from God, it hurts our lives. And it hurts our calling. Why? Well, remember, the priest, God called the Levites to minister in the house. That we mean in the house. They are the Levites, and they were called to be holy. They were something they had, and it says holiness. They belong to God, and they need to be holy, because otherwise they will die right there in the middle of the glory. And right now it says, where war pursues, that we may pursue them. Peace with all your people and holiness. Say with me, holiness. Yes, we have to have peace with everybody. You know, we bless everybody. We don't contend with anyone. We just have peace. We bless everybody. But we have to pursue in holiness. It's not coming just like, whoa, just like going to the beach and get the sun and get tan. That's not holiness working. We need to pursue holiness. We need to take decisions. Actually, let me tell you the definition of resolution. Resolution means a firm decision to do or not to do something. That's what a resolution is. Some people say, I have a resolution for 2017. What is it? I'm not going to eat more chocolate. And I'm like, okay, I'm going to start that. And by February, it's done. What happened with resolution? Oh, I couldn't do it. Well, we have to understand something. Our lives, say with me, our lives need to move in holiness every day. There's a great movie that I love and I like. It is called Pursuing the Happiness. It's with you know, the man that he wants to be a great, on the Wall Street, I believe, or something like that. And then he just wants to work really hard. And he actually pursues. He said, I'm gonna have some trials over there. And they said, but we're not going to pay you. He said, I don't care. I want to stay there. I want to pursue what I believe. Actually, he, in the story, he ended up sleeping with his son in the subway bathroom right there that night. He didn't have money, but he was sacrificed himself to get the job. You know, it's sometimes something. Pursuing is means sacrifice. Say with me, sacrifice. Because there's no victory without sacrifice. Say with me, there is no victory without sacrifice. And if we really want revival, if we really want awakening, we all, say with me, we all need to work in our holiness. If we really want a harvest and a blessing of God, then I have to start a plan and a radical decision in my life to say, you know what? I'm going to live holy and I'm going to remove this out of my life. I'm going to remove this program, this TV show. I used to watch a program that I used to like and I watch it every night. And Holy Spirit told me, do not watch more than a program because it's hurting your heart. And I'm going to tell you which one is. But he said, do not watch it anymore. And you're like, but nothing. Holiness. And say, okay, God. There's some things that we cannot watch. Holy Spirit, forgive me. He told me to change the batteries before I start, but I didn't listen. So forgive me, Holy Spirit. I need to obey you every time. Sometimes people put you something in your mind and says, I don't think it's Holy Spirit. It is Holy Spirit. But look what he says in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 17. Verse 7. What he says? For God did not call us to what? To uncleanness. But what? In holiness. Because if we understand the word of God, God is waiting for us to be holy every day in a greater level. And I believe next year, it needs to be a year where we, the church, we, the leaders, we, the ones that serve in the house of the Lord, we need to understand something. We need to be holy because He is holy. When we walk in holiness, we're going to see the glory of God. When we walk in holiness, we're going to see more of God in our lives. The problem is sometimes we just pretend to be holy, but we don't take decisions in our lives to be holy. Oh, but I'm reading the Bible, Pastor. Yes, but you're still watching those things. Oh, yes, but I'm worshiping, Pastor. Yes, but you still listen to that kind of music. Yes, I'm worshiping. But I'm good in church. Yes, but you haven't forgiven your brother. Listen, we need to take radical decisions, and we mean radical decisions in our lives to be holy. God is waiting for us because He didn't call us to be what? No, don't remove it, please. He called us not to be uncleanness, but in holiness. He is seeking people that is willing to say, God, no more. I'm not going to move anymore in this thing. I'm not going to go in the same circle anymore. I'm going to go in a holy season. I'm going to move in a holy glory because I want revival and awakening in my life. Some people need to throw some things out of your house. And I don't want to be radical. Some people don't want me to go to their houses. You know why? Because they're worried, what can I find over there? It's true. Can I go to your house? Oh, no, Pastor. Why not? I'm going to be busy. Oh, yeah, right. Because something's going on in your house, and you don't want me to see it. Because we are, listen, I believe sometimes it's inside, God is speaking to us, and we still refuse to obey. Israel had a conquer to do. Israel, he said, come on, take the nation to conquering. And when they took Jericho, somebody took something that wasn't holy. God, something took something that it would belong to the enemy, but he hid it because he liked it. Oh, I like gold. I like this mantle, and nobody's going to see it. Well, let me tell you something. God can see everything. Say with me, everything. Yet I cannot see it, but God can. I don't know what's under your bed, but God knows it. And you have to understand something. God is waiting for us to be holy. Because without holiness, we're going to see God in our lives. Without holiness, we're going to not see revival and awakening. We're going to see, you know what we're going to see? The same thing all over and over and over and again. That's why you see Christians 10, 15 years in the same place, going in circles, in circles, in circles, because never they took a radical decision to say no more to this. And we have to understand something. God is calling us today to say no more. Say with me, no more. And the word is press on. Press on holiness. What you need to do? Why you need to get out of your house? Why you need to get out of your DVD player? Why you get out of your internet? Why you need to get out of your mind? Because holiness is what the house of God needs. There's not really famous this teaching. They want to be, people want to be all prospering, blessing. Oh, I want money. Oh, yes, I want this, I want this. But what about holiness? Because without holiness, we're not going to see revival and awakening. God is calling us to be holy. God is calling us to say no more, no more. I remember I used to have a lot of CDs in my life. And music that I didn't belong to God. Listen, I still pray for those guys to become Christians. Woohoo! Amen. Because I used to like that music. I used to love that music. But one day Holy Spirit said, no more. You cannot do that anymore. And I said, God, but listen, this is original music. This is no pirate music. You know, I didn't download this from the internet. I bought them original. I said, get out of here. Get them out of here. Because you need to be holy. Because the plan that I have for you is great. And you want to see more of your glory? And say, yes, God, I want to see more of your glory. Well, reduce then what you like and start putting what I like in your heart. Romans chapter 6, verse 22. I believe holiness is the key of revival, church. Without holiness, we're going to start seeing the same thing. And let me tell you something. We have talked with Pastor Dan about this. We don't want to be 50 and 100. It's more. We want to be thousands. Amen. I don't know if you want to be in the same place. I don't. I want to go higher and higher. I want a revival. And it says, if I have to keep something at my house, well, I will do it. Something that I cannot keep my house is the doggy. Has to stay in my house. But it's some things that you have to remove out of your cell phone. I know it's some things that you have to remove out of your computer. Maybe you have to remove somebody from your friends. Oh, but Pastor, I need to share the gospel. Yes, but get strong first and then you share the gospel. Because a blind man cannot lead another blind, because otherwise they're going to what? Fall in the hole. Some people say, oh, Pastor, but I cannot remove it from my Facebook. They need to share Jesus. They need to see Jesus. Yes, but you are more into them than them into you. So get strong first, and then you share Jesus. Because some people need to remove what's not holy. You know, sometimes Facebook, that's why we just have to just unfollow. And I like Pastor Diana. Pastor Diana told me, honey, unfollow. You know, and maybe you have to unfollow somebody. Maybe you have to unfollow some things in your life. In order to right to perfection, in order to move in what? Say with me, holiness. Romans 6:22 said this, but now having said, now having been set free from sin and having become what? Slaves of God, you have your fruit to what? Come on, read it with me, please. Holiness, and to the end, everlasting life. The work of Christianity, listen, your spirit receives justification. Your body will receive a glorified body, but your soul needs to experience holiness. And it's a progressive holiness. That is, it has to be increased every day, every month, every year of your life. You need to be more holy. But it starts with you. Say, so we may start with me. Because sometimes we just say, okay, just please God, come. No. God is waiting for you to take decisions. God is waiting for you. Says, if you move, I move. Because sometimes, I'm weak. Yeah, we all are weak. But we need to take radical decisions in our lives. You know, remember the movie? Right? Fireproof. You know, he didn't want to let the computer go. Oh, it's my computer. Oh, it's the money for my boat. Oh, it's me. But one day he grabbed that baseball bat and he put that computer outside and he took a radical decision. You know what? I don't need this computer anymore. And sometimes we have to be like that in order to what? To pursue, say we mean holiness. Come on, say we mean holiness. We need to be holy in the middle of the darkness. The glory of God the city needs the glory of God. Our family needs the glory of God. Our nation needs the glory of God. And the only way we're going to see glory is being holy. And we need to be holy every day. With what we see, with what we hear. You know, some Christians are still in gossiping. What a shame. We need to close our ears and understand that I need to be holy. I need to be like Jesus is. I have Holy Spirit in my heart. I need my Holy Spirit dwells in my life. I need to move in holiness because no, of the fear of God that is, oh, He's going to send fire and He's going to burn me and He's going to kill me. Not that fear, but the fear to say, God, I don't want to extinguish the Holy Spirit. I don't want to make the Holy Spirit cry inside of me. I don't want you to feel the present Holy Spirit shrinking in my heart. That's the fear that we need to feel in our lives. We need to understand something. We need to understand that we are called, say with me, we are called to be holy. You know, we are leaders, we are servants of God, we know the word of God, we believe in Jesus. We are called to be what? Say with me, holy. And I finish with one verse, Philippians 3:12. Danny, can you come? Because I believe somebody was stepped on the cajito. Un callito en el dedo. ¿Cómo se llama? How do you call that in English? A what? Yeah, somebody. I step on a toe. Somebody here. Oh, that hurt. Oh, I don't. Listen. People is delivered when people is willing to let it go. I learned that in deliverance. Because some people wants to be delivered. Now pray for me, Pastor. Pray for me, Pastor. Pray for me. I pray for me, Pastor Diana. Pray for me, Pastor Diana. And we pray for those people and nothing happens. You know why? Because inside their lives, they don't want to let it go. Oh, but I want to change. No, you are not want to change. But I want to change for real. Oh, really? You're still tied to it. You know why? Because you still love it inside. You need to let it go. We need to be holy. And look what the Apostle Paul says here in Philippians chapter 3 verse 12. It says, not that I already obtained holiness. Speaking about holiness, about the purpose of God. Or I'm already perfected. But I am pressed on. And I believe that the teaching, press on. That I may lay hold for that which Christ Jesus has also laid hold of me. It's not that Bill, it's not that Apostle Paul was holy. Has the like I said on the discipleship, the only person who's an angel here is Julian. But because the last name, that's it. It's a lot of things to work right there. But we are no angels. I'm no angel. I'm a sinner. Are you? But before God, I need to take a radical decision. Says God, I need to be holy. And yes, I'll still make mistakes, but I'm unwilling. Say with me, I'm unwilling to obey Holy Spirit. So can you stand up? The New Living Translation says this: I don't mean to say that I already achieved these things or that I already reached perfection, but I press on to possess the perfection for which Jesus Christ first possessed me. And I believe God calls us to be holy, church. If we really want to see revival and awakening in our lives, we need to be holy. And you can be holy here in the house, I know that, because we glorify. But holiness is not just here in the house. Holiness is when you are in your home, when you are in your car, when you are in your living room, when you are in your bedroom, when you are in a school, when you are at work and nobody else is seeing. Is people looking at you with holiness? I told you that I work with a man that used to swear all the time. And every time that he says, like, please, come on. Please, come on. And he just got mad. I said, why you don't like it? He says, because I don't do it. Because I'm Christian. Oh, but I'm, you know. He says, please, can you stop doing that? And every time he saw me, he never said anything. Not even a bad word. People need to know that we are holy. Not that we are Christian or religious. But you know why we have to be holy? Not because Pastor said, it's because our Father demands that we need to be holy. Oh, but I don't go to church because they prohibit smoke and drinking and partying. No, we don't prohibit anything. We just don't do it because our Father doesn't like it. And we do what our Father wants because we love Him with all our hearts. And we honor Him. And we respect the calling. And we respect who's living inside of us. Just like a pregnant woman. Do you drink? No. Smoke? No. Why? I'm pregnant. You know, actually, it says, do not take it if you are pregnant. It can hurt the baby. There's some things that we cannot take, that we don't need to see, that we need not even think about it, because it can hurt who living inside of us. Actually, the Bible says, think about those things that are righteous. Think about holiness. Think about goodness. God is waiting for us to move and pursue and press on in holiness. Listen, I don't have to come to your house to say, you have to do this and this and this and oh, look at these videos, remove those things. Oh, look at those newspapers. Oh, remove that. No, I don't have to do that. Holy Spirit is the one that is touching your life right now. And you know, and you know, and you triple know what you need to do in your life. And you triple know that you need to remove things in your heart. Otherwise, we're not going to see more of God in our lives. How many want more of God? I want to finish with this verse. Jesus said, no, let's, 2 Corinthians 7:1. It's the verse that I share first. Therefore, having these promises, say with me, I have promises. Come on, say with me, I have promises. Beautiful, say with me, beautiful. Say with me, amazing promises. So what I need to do? Well, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and the spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of God. Come on, let's close your eyes for a moment. And let's start saying, God, I want revival. I want awakening. I want a supernatural movement of God in my life. But I know holiness is the key of the glory. The increasing glory will come when holiness takes place in our lives. And this church needs holiness in every step of the way. This church needs holiness, and everyone here needs the word of holiness. So, Father, there's things in our lives that maybe got attached during this 2016. There's some things that we are watching that need to be removed. There's some things in our cell phones that need to be removed. But Father, reveal that to our hearts today. Reveal the truth of your word. Just bright your glory like a lamp, so it can manifest the darkness, the small things that need to be removed out of our lives. I will do it. We want to do it because we want more of you. Come on, somebody. If somebody here needs to walk in holiness, in a deepened glory, you can say, God, reveal that to me and I will remove that out of my life. Reveal that to me, God. Speak to me, Lord, today. Tell me which TV shows. Tell me what kind of things on the internet. Even sometimes what kind of feelings I have in my heart that it needs to remove out of my mind. Some people have bitterness, selfishness, depression. And it's not that you need 12 sessions. It's not you need a radical decision in your life. Some people have double mind and you need to take a radical decision and say, no more, no more. I'm going to cleanse myself in the glory of God. I'm going to cleanse myself. I'm going to cleanse my house. I'm going to cleanse my marriage. I'm going to cleanse those things that don't keep me holy. Because I want to see the glory of God in a higher level. Because I want revival. Because I want awakening. Because I want, Lord, miracles, wonders, and signs. And I know I need the glory. And the moment I move into holiness and a new level, that's the moment where glory will take place in a higher level in my heart. Come on, take a moment to pray. And ask the Holy Spirit what I need to remove in my life. What I need to remove in my home. What I need to remove out of my mind. Because I am willing to take that resolution for the next year. I'm going to press on. I'm going to pursue in holiness. And I'm going to keep believing that you have a great purpose. Come on, you can say, Lord, you have a great plan. You have a great idea for me. You have a great promises for me and my family. Lord Jesus, and I'm gonna take them all in Jesus' name. I'm going to take them all in Jesus' name. I'm going to take them all by the power of the Holy Ghost. By the power of the Holy Spirit today. I believe. Come on, if somebody believe it, pray. Pray and ask Holy Spirit what I need to remove in my life. Maybe something reduced the time of your prayer. Something reduced the time of your consecration. The Bible says we are from glory to glory. No backwards but forward. So today, take a radical decision in your life. Take a radical decision for your wife. Take a radical decision for your husband. Take a radical decision for your kids. Take a radical decision for your future. Because if you don't take that radical decision and you still attach to those things, you're going to keep walking in circles and circles, and you will never ever cross the river into the promised land. Because the victory comes when you obey the Holy Spirit. When you obey the voice of Jesus Christ, that it says that blessed is the man that he have a clean heart, because he will see God. So yes, we can have a clean heart, but everything starts with when you take a radical decision. One day you took a decision to follow Christ. So today, take a radical decision to say, God, I'm going to go higher in holiness in my life. I'm going to go in the deeper compromise. I'm going to be more into you, Holy Spirit, this year. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, just a few minutes more. 5 minutes more in the glory. Come on, come on, come on. I know God is revealing something right now. And maybe your mind is blocking it. Maybe your heart doesn't want to accept it. But let the Holy Spirit reveal the truth right now. Holy Spirit, break our lies. Break our own excuses. David said, deliver me, God, from the sins that I don't see it. God, Father, open my hearts today. And let us see what we don't see. If it's something in my house that doesn't please you, it is something in my marriage that doesn't please you. It is something at work. It is something in my school that doesn't please you. I want to remove it and cleanse my life because I want to walk in the glory of God. I want to see a movement of glory in this nation. And somebody needs to do it. And that person is going to be me, Lord Jesus. see your glory. I want to see the glory. Come on, if you already dressed yourself, if you took that decision today, come on, sing it with us. It's a glory, glory, glory.
Show me your glory.
Show me your glory, Lord. I'm not ready. I want to be ready for the glory. Glory. I want more, 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 more.
Lost in your eyes.
There's somebody here that is behind in things and nobody knows, but you have to, God is saying, remove those things. Remove those things. Before those things consume you. Before those things extinguish the Holy Spirit. Remove those things before the enemy brings pain into your life. Right now, right now, right now, right now, right now. Somebody needs to say, God, I need to remove this. Help me. Give me the strength and give me the authority to kick them out of my life forever, forever, forever in Jesus' name. Holiness. I'm going to walk in holiness. I'm going to pursue holiness. I'm going to press on holiness. In Jesus' mighty name. Come on, sing with us.
It shall be.
To you, and I open my house, I open my room, I open my mind and my life, my entire life to you. Cleanse whatever you need to remove in my life, or show me those things that maybe I brought to my house, I brought to my life, that is holding me back from victory, because I know that holiness is the part that in my life that I need to work in this 2017. Because we want your glory like we're singing right now. So Lord, we declare that this house will experience holiness. We declare that this glory will experience your glory in a new level of presence right now. I know that 2017 will be a year of harvest because people are taking radical decisions today. And I know that the enemy is leaving our houses. The enemy is leaving our minds and our souls and our spirits. So Father, today we declare that we're going to press on, that we're going to keep walking in holiness, that we're going to keep believing and being holy, that we're going to obey the Holy Spirit, and we're going to guard our hearts every day in our minds, and we're going to guard what our eyes see, because we want to take care of the presence of God in our lives. So Father, we want to thank you for your word today. We declare that we are holy, that we are holy in your glory, in your presence, that we are going from glory to glory in Jesus' mighty name, that we are going from victory, to manifest your presence in this nation, to manifest your glory among your people. So we declare that this church is a place of glory, a place of holiness, because we declare that you are the one that we want, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Long to look on the face of the one that I love. Long to stay in your presence.
Come on, stay with me.
Where
I
long
to look on the face of the one that
long
I love. You, Jesus,
on
you,
the face
you are.
Of the one.
show that glory, show that glory, Lord. Lord, we want to thank you for what you're doing right now. Father, we declare that we're leaving this place transformed. Transformed by instruction. Being holy because I am holy. So Lord, we declare that next year we're going to see a great harvest in our lives. So Father, we cover ourselves with the blood of Jesus. And we declare that we have the armor of God, the full armor of God in our lives. The belt of the truth, the blessed belt of righteousness, the shoes of the gospel of peace, the shield of faith, the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the spirit. We declare victory in a great season, that because the best is yet to come. In Jesus' mighty name, and we say together, amen and amen. Give a mighty applause to Jesus today.